Hey guys, I'm Chris Egnoto, and you're watching my YouTube channel, so thank you very much for that. Now, it's late March, it's around 10 o'clock at night, it's actually 57, 58 degrees out right now, raining, and I saw some lightning. Perfect conditions for what I'm about to show you. So, I've been hitting the vernal pools the past couple of weeks, waiting to catch the salamanders coming out for the spring breeding. A lot of them come out really early in the season. They like dark rainy nights like this. It keeps predators away and also gives them the moisture that they need to get from the upper woodlands down into those vernal pools to breed. So tonight I stopped by the vernal pool and it was half covered in ice. I looked through the ice and I happened to see several spotted salamanders. And here you go. This is the species I am talking about. Check that out. Isn't that amazing? Oop, I almost dropped her. I think this one is a female. Look at that. The spotted salamander. Ambystoma maculatum. Now the name Ambystoma, some people say it means cup mouth. The guy who described this, his name's Jacob something, way back in the day, who found these, he made a mistake and he said Ambystoma, but he meant to say Amblistoma with an L, which means wide mouth. It's really debated as to what that word really means. Some people say cup mouth, other people say wide mouth. And as you see, these guys have a very wide mouth. So it's got a pretty wide mouth on them. Okay, I think this one's a female because her cloaca is kind of large and swollen right down there. That's the opening for sexual organs and breeding and whatnot. As I said, this is one of my favorite species. These guys are just really cool. They're members of the mole salamanders. So usually the males, I think, get to the pool first before the females to breed. Now it's not unusual for spotted salamanders to reach 7 or 8 inches. This one is pretty much, that's how long this one is, pretty much. Look at that large mouth on the salamander. Isn't that impressive? Now, the salamanders will use that large mouth, or the spotted salamanders use that mouth, for catching prey such as worms, millipedes, crickets, spiders, all sorts of little invertebrates. And some resources actually say that they feed on other salamanders once in a while. I wouldn't be surprised. I'm pretty sure I saw one feeding on a young two-line salamander once. Spotted salamanders can be known to come out when there's still ice on the vernal pools. The reason why they like vernal pools is because a vernal pool doesn't have fish breeding in it. And because the fish will just eat all their eggs. So a vernal pool is a pool that fills up seasonally from the rain and snow melting. It fills up for several months of the year and it also spends several months of the year being dry. So that's what one of the main characteristics of a vernal pool. Salamanders love to breed in them because they're safer for their offspring. Also, they can get a jump on the breeding season because they come out very early when there's still ice in the ground. So that allows them to lay their eggs, which will hatch in a couple of months. And the pool won't be dried up by that point, usually. That's pretty impressive. The eggs also have what's known as a beneficial algae, which is also called Ambystoma ophelia or something like that. I don't know. But the eggs have a beneficial algae that is within the egg itself because the egg is somewhat watertight and it's oxygen tight. So the algae will produce oxygen from photosynthesis, providing the developing embryo with oxygen. And in return, the embryo produces carbon dioxide, which the algae feeds off of. So it's definitely a beneficial relationship between the two things. Really cool stuff. So another cool thing about these salamanders is when it is time to breed, they'll do something I like to call the salamander rains. Nights like this where it's 50s and pretty rainy and nice and dark, they'll come out and migrate across the lands coming from deciduous mixed, well, pretty much deciduous upland hills with beech trees and oaks and maples, and cross the land by the thousands for these vernal pools in order to breed. And then you can go there a night or two later and not find a single one. Just nothing but their egg masses, which are a few inches in diameter, 2 to 3 inches usually, milkish, a milky bluish color, and you'll have about 100 eggs per egg mass. And as I said earlier, those eggs will hatch in a couple of months, depending on the temperatures and conditions. So we're gonna turn her loose.
There's dozens of them.
That is a juvenile marbled salamander,
hence the orange colorations.
Look at the size of that one. That's pushing 9 or 10 inches, something like that. I let this little guy go. Those grooves there are called costal grooves. Salamanders don't have ribs, so they can get injured pretty easily. Their internal organs can get damaged. So let's let this little one go, okay? Oh, big one actually. Something else that's pretty amazing about these spotted salamanders, as you can tell, they're swimming right out from underneath this ice. They're breeding in very cold water. You can see my breath. And you can see the ice and everything. They're going underneath it and coming out from underneath it. Every once in a while, one will come up to the surface to grab a breath of air. Better oxygen, I guess. I'm Chris Egnoto. Thanks for watching my YouTube. Signing out.